Hello guys and welcome back. In today's video I'm going to paint black the rubbing streaks. If you remember in a previous video I have sanded down the surface is smooth like silk, also have filled it where needed. You can see here this line is wood putty, so I'm going to have no gaps at this point. Everything is smooth, everything is perfect, everything is ready to be painted black. If you have followed any of my previous constructions, you already know that I use only gloss paint. So, for that reason, I'm going to use gloss by Humbrol. It's the black one. But before using the gloss, for those who are new in this modeling about wooden model ships, you must know that the wood has pores. So if I apply just paint over to these surfaces, then the wood will absorb the paint, and I have to use two, maybe three coats of paint, even four sometimes. I don't believe I need four for black, but sometimes four. I'd like to do that with just one coat of paint right now, because everything we need repainting or probably some micro corrections after, because here we're going to have a lot of work later. We have to place gun ports, we have to place, don't remember how they called, these platforms here for the dead eyes. We have to place, I see, this part here. Also, I don't believe you can see it, here, the officer's quarters. So we're going to have a lot of work later. So there's no point to make it perfect. If it gets perfect, no problem with that, but if it doesn't get perfect, then no problem again, because I can correct it always later. Before starting painting the black, I'm going to use some wood sealer as undercoat. For those of you who are new again, and many of you ask me, not about Wolf. Wolf, say hi to everyone. Say hi to Jeff, to George, to Damian. Jeff, as you can see, I've got him a conch ball, because this is the fifth tennis ball. I'd like to see your Wolf destroying that. He sigh. So, back to our modeling. The wood sealer I use, let me find it. No, this is the varnish. Varnish again. Yeah, this is it. This is the wood sealer I'm using. It's by Vernilac. Don't buy the Greek. It's Nitro Sealer, the number 1419. 1419. And also, I use this Nitro Thinner. This is the product. And I'm trying to have the liquid, as you can see, like this. So, again, before starting applying the sealer, let me tell you a little secret about that. The sealer must be applied in this surface and this surface. Also, we have this small surface here. And underneath, of course. I'm going to paint black. I don't have any problem of painting this surface black, but I'm going to have a small problem in this surface. Probably my paintbrush will miss its target, and maybe I will paint a little black at this light yellow wood. This is going to be a problem, because I don't need any black in this surface. But if I use some wood sealer and I do not use wood sealer in the tire surface, because if I do, then everything that is going to be glued on later will be glued very, very difficult. The cyanoacrylic glue is not very good in applying in painted surfaces, because it applies on the paint, and if you heat it or push it a little bit harder, it goes off with the paint and a part of the wood. So if I apply a little sealer more excess this part, a little more to this part, I will be able to scratch off with this small tool any paint that goes over this wood and over to the yellow one. I did that with the red. You can see the right here, it's scratched off, and I have created a very beautiful line. So this is the little secret. Let me adjust the camera on a tripod and get started. So guys, the camera is on the way, but I believe I can manage. Now, see what I was talking about. Just a small amount of wood sealer underneath and above. This small amount will allow me to scratch off any black paint I applied by mistake. So you get the idea, guys. Let me do that in the entire side, also the other one, and I'll get back to you to paint it black. So guys, all the surfaces, front, back, and on the other side, are covered with this wood sealer. The wood sealer has the ability to dry very fast, so until I apply wood sealer on the other side, this one is dry. Now, for applying in this, at this surface the black, I'm going to use a paint brush. As you can see, it's flat and it's number 4. I don't know if it's visible, it's has washed out during the years. I'm not going to do the bow because I need to facing it, not to do any mistakes, so I'm not going to able to be to paint it on the camera. So I'm going to start painting the here to see how it goes, and then I'm going to finish it and show you the finished result. But before, I'm going to show you how I'm going to paint these small surfaces here and underneath. The only problem here is not to touch the painted areas, because it's black, it's going to get on your fingers and everything you touch, and you don't want to mess this nice, beautiful, smooth material. So, let's begin. paint black, you need very good lights. And very good eyes. And of course, steady hand. As you see, it's getting along. I want to paint this part here before continue, because I don't want the paint dry and I will be able to see the connection. So, excuse me, but like I said, I cannot film that. I need to turn the ship and be on top. So, let me paint the entire hull, both sides, the rubbing straights in both sides, and I'll get back to you. So, guys, as you can see, it is painted. I have some points like this one that I have to scratch off the paint. I will use the technique that I told you. Not right now. The paint must be dry first. As you can see, it looks magnificent. But now, I have to paint over there. So, let me get the camera on tripod and I'll get back to you. Of course, I'm going to show you a little part. I'm not going to film the entire painting. I'm going to use this paintbrush. Is 10/0. Is the thinner paintbrush I can find. As you can see, it's very, very small. So, let's do it. Very difficult. Let's see if I can show you some work on the bow. You see, it's a very delicate job, very difficult. This is the way to do it. No need to film it. All the process, no need about that. So, this is, guys, how to paint the rubbing strakes black. I was thinking, guys, to finish the video, but then it came to my attention that I haven't shown you how to clear this little paint over the yellow wood. So now that the paint is dry, I will try to do that on camera. It's a bit hard, but I believe I can manage. So, if you remember, I have placed a layer of sealer, wood sealer, and now I'm going to try to scratch it in camera. As you see, the paint scratches away. Perfect. Let me change the camera view and do another one. Let's do this one. What I'm scratching right now, very smoothly, is the paint above the layer of the wood sealer. So I'm not scratching entirely the wood. The wood is in perfect condition. Perfect. You can see it here, you can. So, I have to do the entire part along the hull, both sides. What I haven't done at the moment, and I won't be filming it, it's the paint I have to, the black paint I have to use for the gun ports to simulate the depth. But that's not something that I need to film. It's not something that is hard to be done. So, I will do all this part. Let me give you a view of the entire model. As you can see, the black makes it look even better. So, this, guys, concludes this video. Thank you very much for being with me. You're very welcome to join me to the next video, where I'm going to place this front piece and all the piece from bow to stern below. Thank you very much for watching. See you soon.